things we do that maybe are
super. Collaboration has always been a big part of my process. This project has adapted fundamentally from the inception to where I am currently sitting, no doubt about it. My artistic output up until this point has been very much based on this idea of resonant material. We look through a window, you and I, and we see a tree. And the life in that tree comes through the window, and it hits our eyes, and our rods and cones fire, and we see that tree. My argument, based off of the stuff I was seeing in these windows, is that some of the energy from there to here gets caught in that glass. So every time I look out a window and I have an interaction with light energy with a tree or a flower or a piece of sidewalk or sky, some of that's getting caught in that glass. Until over years and years and years and years, this energy just builds and resonates. It was natural for me to want to do more than just paint on it, right? So I started building out what I was seeing with layers of cardboard. Now, cardboard like glass has that same sort of energy. Like, it's been somewhere, it's been on a journey, people have touched it, it's carried things. So that too also has a sort of resonating energy in it for me, to the point that it's really moldable and really sculptable. Polarity's initial proposal to me was that I build a robot costume. That's what was brought to me. Would you be willing to build a robot costume? Because as with my artwork, working with glass and resonant material, cardboard was something I was playing with more and more. And I ended up doing quite a bit of cardboard sculpture that made me sort of a nice candidate for a good, low-cost, artistically done and or sturdy robot costume. The idea of creating a unified look was I thought was going to be really key to the idea of the production design. Right now I'm using a three blue palette. There's three different blues that are at work in everything in the set. A lot of care has been taken to allow Kaylin the ability to actually move, to recognize that the way he moves throughout the set is going to be key to the visual. You know, there's a lot of effort taken to making sure that he can move in the range that he needs to move in. You know, my immediate thought, of course, is it's gonna be a robot, he's gonna move like a robot, I'm gonna do whatever I wanna do with it, because he could, you know, robots move the way robots move. But in collaborating with Kaylin and seeing how Kaylin's developing Manuel, there's more thought to saying okay, let's make it more movable in this fashion. If Kaylin can do a back bend, let's make Manuel able to do that so he can actually embrace the full range of his movement. So that's a huge factor. Can the actor move in this piece of artwork? I like spectacle a lot. So the idea of the robot costume was like an open door to ooh, we can make a spectacle here. Thinking one step ahead. My immediate thought was, okay, why don't we make this more? I'm not just coming on as a design member, but I'm coming on as an artist, a working artist, stepping in, creating a visual world from scratch that reinforces the play and reinforces the director's vision and still has the ability to stand on its own as its own contribution. Right.